talking about Psalms 18, verse 18.
I've been changed. Yeah, I've been healed.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. You can be seated if you'd like. Praise the Lord. You've served him 1 second. You've served him too long. Look back or turn back. Amen. Praise God. 1 Samuel 16 and 13. Samuel anointed David from that day forward. You can only access the anointing power of God that liberates, that delivers, when you're determined to move forward, to move on. You can't access the power of God turning back, quit. Going back. Somebody say forward. Somebody been praying for direction. Look at your neighbor and say, you got it, forward. When God anointed David, he anointed him from that day. Somebody say forward. Somebody say anointed to move forward. Next time you want to quit, most times you do, you look down at your feet, first place you look. The next time you do, remember that your feet are nothing but prophetic arrows pointing in one direction. Boy, how beautiful are the feet of those who bring glad tidings of good things. Romans 10:16. Amen. Somebody say, how beautiful are the feet? Those that bring the gospel of peace. Man, your feet's preaching to you every time you want to quit. Every time you want to give up, every time you want to just say, what's the use? Let me just turn around. Amen. Your feet, every time you look down, because that's what people do when they're down. They look down. Come on, somebody. Amen. Remember, your feet's telling you. Get your chin up off your chest. Put your eyes straight ahead. Don't you turn to the left, don't to the right. Go forward. Somebody say forward. Moses got to the Red Sea. Mountains were all around him, and Pharaoh coming, amen, with his army at his back to kill him. Amen, they're hemmed in, they don't know what they're going to do. Amen, and God says, let me go ahead and fix the situation. Amen, let me just set it right here, Exodus 15:13. He said, Moses, amen, why are you crying to me? Speak to this people and tell them, go forward, brother, verse 15. In other words, God told Moses, dry your eye, quit whining, son, quit weeping. Amen, glory to God, stop fretting over this. Tell my people to go forward. Go walk up to that Red Sea, stretch out the rod I gave you. Hallelujah. And I'll move the waters out of the way and I'll drag the enemy behind you. Glory to God. Look at your neighbor and say, you don't have to climb the mountain. Praise God. But you can cross the sea. Whatever's in front of you, between you and what the Holy Ghost said he wanted you to do. Amen. The only way you're going to ever see it is if you are determined to go forward. I dare you to tap somebody on the shoulder and say, excuse me, I'm moving forward. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Right before God told Moses to tell his people to go forward, he told him in verses 13, he said, you shall see this in the henceforth no more forevermore. Exodus 13. Verse 13. In other words, God said, Moses, just take one little last good glimpse over your shoulder. Left, right shoulder, don't make no difference. Just look back. It's our army that's coming. Remember, because you won't see them no more. And he told him, he said, I want you to stand still and see my salvation. Right before God said go forward, he said be still. Sometimes we think we're not doing nothing when we're still. But look at your neighbor and say, still, going forward. Still. When I get still, that means when the enemy's attacking me and saying quit and throw in the towel and turn around and go back to from where you came from, somebody shout, that's a time to get still. Be still and know I'm God, Psalms 46 verse 10. Somebody say still. Don't let Satan steal your steal. If he can steal your steal, he'll make you go back. But if you never get still long enough in the presence of God, that steal means call on the Lord. That means call out Jesus. Still don't just mean I'm just sitting around doing nothing, but it means get still before the Lord. Concentrate on him. Begin to call out to him. And I promise you, you start calling out to him, your direction will not be your past. It will not be backward. Come on. Zephaniah 1, verses 6, the Bible said that they did not inquire of the Lord and they turned back. Inquire means they didn't pray. There's no way you can go back if you call on him. If you keep spending time with him and get still with him, come on somebody. Psalm 4, verses 4, David declared the word of the Lord. Amen. He said, I will be still and commune with my own heart upon my bed. Selah. In other words, he was not talking about I'm going to sit here and talk to myself. He's just talking about in the spirit, I'm about to get in touch with God. And he was doing it on his bed. He just got still. Somebody said, oh, let Satan steal your steel. Because if he steals your steel, you won't go forward. Because before Moses can hear God say, tell him to go forward, he said, first be still, because I want to show you myself. He said, and God said, I want to show you my salvation. He said, I want to show you me, because I am salvation. Come on, somebody. And if you ever get a glimpse of me, you won't want to turn back. You won't want to go back. Amen.
Amen.
I was still hunting this morning in that house. Brother DJ took it too. I'll get claustrophobic. I used to be hunting and something like that. Come on, somebody. I mean, you can't hunt in that place. I had to take my coveralls off. They got warm in there. Because no wind get to me. Hello? Now, I didn't find no deer, but I did find a D-E-A-R, dear Jesus. Come on, somebody. I'm still hunting. Glory to God. I got Jesus. Come on, somebody. I told Brother DJ, better tell his brother, amen, they feel something familiar up in there. It'll be a familiar spirit. It'll be Holy Spirit. Amen. Because I shook the whole house this morning. I'm telling you, the Holy Ghost come up in there. I was steel hunting. I forgot I was there for hunting for a deer. Come on. Amen. I was after dear Jesus. I got steel. Somebody say steel before it. Praise God. Amen. And when you get steel before it, I'll shake it. There'll something happen. Come on, church. Hallelujah. And I'm telling you, Father, when you get steel with him, friend, you'll hear him say in the middle of stillness, forward. Go forward. And when God tells you to go forward, that means I got your back. Amen. I'll take care of enemies behind you. The only way you're going to see Satan defeated is you can't run. You can't retreat every time he attacks you. Come on. David said in Psalms 11, in verses 1, many are telling me, voices are saying to me, won't you flee like a bird to your mouth? Flee like a bird to your mouth. He said, I will put my trust in the Lord.
Amen.
In other words, I'm going to trust God and I'm going to face it. Look at your neighbor and say, you can't change nothing you're unwilling to confront. You can't run every time. Retreat only going to bring defeat. Praise God. You can't run every time something happens. If you're going to run, you got to run to him. Come on. The Bible says in Psalms chapter 118. Even or thank you, Holy Ghost. Proverbs 18:10. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it and are saved. Somebody say, run into it. That's a passage of prayer. That's a passage in the Word of God of prayer. It's not just feeding. Amen. Glory to God. Well, the name of the Lord is a strong tower. Glory to God. Yes, a strong tower. Praise God. This tower, no terrorist can knock down. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. This tower, these strong towers. Come on, somebody. The name of the Lord Jesus. Come on, church. When you call on that name, I'm telling you, 1 John 2:32 said, whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be delivered. Psalms 50 verse 15 said, I call upon the Lord in the day of my trouble. He delivered me and I glorified him. Glory to God. Anybody hear the Holy Ghost? Praise God. Call on me. I will answer you and show you great mighty things. You know that man. Jeremiah 33 verse 3. Boy, I'd like to see God do great mighty things. Well, how about doing the familiar thing? One thing, he creates an atmosphere for the great and mighty things and the things that are so mighty and great that you've never seen, that you know not of. It is simple prayer. Come on, get in still before the Lord. Friend, if you get still before him and you begin to spend time with him and call on him, I promise you, do it every time you feel like quitting. Amen. Amen. Declare this with me tonight and make a covenant before the Lord. God, next time the devil tells me stop, quit, turn around, leave, throw in the towel, I'm going to call on your name for about 5 minutes before I actually do it. You call on his name, you'll find yourself after being still before him and spending time with him. Come on, somebody. You'll find yourself going forward, 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 forward. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. See, 1 Thessalonians 2, verses 8, I'm going to try to get my message that I think I'm going to preach. Still believe I will. This is early preach. Amen. Praise God. The 1 Thessalonians 2, 18, the Bible records the word of the Lord. Paul said, Paul, would have came to you once and again, but Satan has hindered us. You don't know where in Scripture Paul never said Satan has stopped him. Matter of fact, the last verse of the last chapter of the book of Acts, Acts 28, 31, the Bible said about the ministry of Paul, said he was preaching, listen to this, the things that pertain to the kingdom of God and the Lord Jesus Christ. Come on, Paul didn't just preach Jesus. He preached him as Lord.
Amen.
The one that sanctified.
Amen.
Not just Jesus, the one that saves. And he preached him as Christ, the anointed one.
Amen.
Miracles, power. Come on, somebody. That's a whole revelation that goes together. When you meet Jesus the Savior, you get saved. Then you got to meet Jesus who's Lord.
Amen.
And let him sanctify and separate you from the sin of this world. Come.
Amen.
in the things of this life. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And then you can step into Jesus, who is Lord and Christ, the power of God. Oh, glory to God. And he preached concerning the kingdom of God, and it said with all confidence. Somebody say with all faith. And it said, this is the last statement of Acts 28:31, no man forbidden him. Word forbidden means no man stopping him. Wow. The book of Acts ends that way. No man stopping Holy Ghost. Look at your neighbor and say, you're looking at it. Acts 29, right here, sitting in the flesh, right beside you. The book of Acts ain't stopped. It continues, because the last verse in the book of Acts says no man stopping it. No man, amen, forbidding it. Come on, church. Hallelujah. Holy Ghost is still the same Holy Ghost as he was then. He still got the same power. Come on, somebody, as he did then. He ain't no different. Glory to God. Malachi 3:6, he said, I'm the Lord, and I've changed. Somebody shout, he's still the same.
He's still the same.
Wow. So Paul said, Satan, I don't give him credit. Satan don't make me stop.
Right.
Somebody say, if you stop,
you stop
you.
Yeah.
You stop you.
Well, the devil made me do it. The devil ain't made you do nothing. The devil don't have the power to make you do anything.
Amen.
We give him too much credit and he loves it.
Jesus was took by Satan to the top of the pinnacle of the temple. And all the glories of earth, amen, he showed. He said, if you bow down and worship me, I'll give you all these things. And Jesus said in Matthew 4:10, get behind me, Satan. For I will only worship the Lord God, and to him shall I only serve.
Amen.
Somebody shout, who you worship is who you serve.
Amen.
And who you worship is more important to you than anyone or anything. You're going to serve somebody. What you worship, what you're most passionate about, is your God. Why? Jesus, before he mentioned worship and serving God, he said, get behind me, Satan. In other words, devil, you're out of place. If you're standing between me and my destiny, if you're standing between me, come on somebody, because what really Satan was trying to do was offer Jesus the world, the kingdoms of the world, come on somebody, without the cross. He would say, if you bow down and worship me, I'll go ahead and give you all these souls. I'll go ahead and give you all the devil's allowance, Father, of John 8:44. Hallelujah. In other words, it's that spirit that still operates today. It's a crossless gospel. Come on, it's a message that's a massage, not a message. Come on, somebody, it's become massage parlors in many pulpits. They don't even preach the cross no more. They don't preach the blood. Come on, anybody here? Yeah. That's the same spirit that worked in the Pharisees, standing at the foot of his cross in Matthew 27 and 42, and they said, look here, if you be the Son of God, save yourself and come down from the cross and we'll believe in you. It's the same spirit of Satan himself that said, get off of the cross and we'll believe in you. Save yourself. But ain't you glad, amen, that they declared the religious crowd, they said he saved others, but he can't even save himself. Ain't you glad he saved others?
Yeah.
No, he said, that's the message of the cross. They said, if you'll get off the cross, we'll believe in you. And Jesus said, no. The only way you can believe in me is if I stay on the cross. You've got to believe in me through this cross. Come on, church.
Yeah.
That's another message. Look at your neighbor and say, we need to stay cross-eyed. Whatever you do in the ministry, stay cross-eyed. Praise God. Hallelujah. But listen, amen. What Jesus is telling the devil here in Matthew 4:10, he's saying, you don't get behind me because you're out of place. And Ephesians 4:27 said, need to get in place with the devil. So devil, you're not going to be in front of me no more. Get behind me. You're telling me if I bow down and worship you, you'll give me all this. No, my Father said, I'm going to suffer on the cross and die, and he's going to give me the reward of my sufferings. Come on, as which any whosoever believes on me and what I did on the cross, glory to God. So I'm not going your route. I'm not going to fall down and worship you. Come on, somebody. I'm not going to turn my back on God. Matter of fact, you're out of your place. You ain't supposed to be in front of me. Get behind me. It's the only place he deserves to be. Somebody say behind you.
Behind.
Now hear this. Back to Paul, 1 Thessalonians 2:18. He said, no man, he said, no, that's Acts 28:31. Paul said, Satan has hindered us. Hindered means momentarily. He has delayed me. But he has not stopped me.
Amen.
And then he said in verse 19, 1 Thessalonians 2:19, he spake to the people he was preaching to. He referred to, amen, his children. in the spirit, his sons and daughters. This is what he said to them in 1 Thessalonians 2:19. He said, "You're my joy and rejoicing, because are not even ye in the presence of the Lord Jesus at his coming?" Somebody say, in the presence of Jesus, when he returns. I don't know about you, that's exactly where I want to be living. That's exactly where I want to be being. Now, I know that may not sound like good English, but I ain't no English teacher. But I believe that's a good place to be being. Somebody say, be being. Praise God. That's about like done being. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I told somebody one time, John 19:30 said, "It's finished." Praise God. That's as serious as I'd be. I said, "Man, you need to shout and rejoice, because everything you think you need him to do, it done did." Come on, somebody. You don't have to keep it done. It done did. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Anybody hear the Holy Ghost? Y'all can tell I'm from the sticks and don't keep it up. Amen. Praise God. But listen, the swamp. Swamp people have arrived in the North Georgia region. Okay. Right. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Cutie. But listen, the Holy Ghost wants us to know tonight. Praise the Lord God. Amen. The devil does not have the power to stop you. He may have power momentarily to hinder you. But if you'll determine to get still before God, come on and call on the name of the Lord and say, "I'm not going any direction but forward." Shout forward, forward. Friend, within God will move that devil out of your way. He'll move that mountain out of your way. Whatever's between you and whatever he told you, you will do in his kingdom before him.
Don't leave that enemy out of the way so you can. But you can't turn back.
Give God praise for that message. Hallelujah. I just heard the Holy Ghost say it. Forward. Somebody say forward.
Forward.
So we're speaking about.